Hi, I'm educator Zac Gordon, and in this video, we're going to talk about some of the great features for developers that Local for Flywheel offers. Now, there are a lot of them, so I'm just going to run down a list real quick, and then we'll circle back and look at how some of these work. We've got the ability to set default blueprints, clone sites for testing, edit server configurations, change PHP versions, speed up Docker, and of course, SSH in and get WP CLI out of the box, extend with a library of add-ons, or build your own custom add-ons. If you're a developer who likes dark UIs, Local's got you covered with their dark mode. Now, let's circle back and look at how some of these work in a bit more depth.
Okay, the first thing I want to show you here is that when we have an existing site running, we have the option to clone it, export it, and save as a blueprint. Clone should make sense. It will create a duplicate copy of the site, great for if you're branching off or testing a feature. Exporting, of course, will give you the full backup. And save as a blueprint will let you save this to be reused as a starter project for other projects. So if you have a bunch of themes or plugins that you like to have or configurations, then you can automatically get them out of the box by saving this as a blueprint. Then in the future, if you ever go to spin up a new site, when you are adding the new site, you have the option to use a blueprint, and here we could see the one that we started with. Super handy feature. Another feature we have if we're setting up a new site is the ability to customize the server configurations, the PHP version, what web server you're using, and the MySQL version. Now, a lot of the times I just recommend using preferred, but if you know the exact configuration of your server that you'll be pushing to, it's a good idea to match your local one to that. Likewise, if you have an existing site, you can come into the local environment and change it from preferred or whatever it is and modify the web server, the PHP version, and the MySQL once again with your running site and save those changes and it will be updated. Local also has some great developer features tucked away in the preferences. First off, we have the ability to switch to a dark mode, which some developers prefer. We could set up a default terminal. For example, I like to use different ones in the default terminal app for Mac. We could set up our new site defaults to be a certain customized environment and set the corresponding configurations that we want, including turning on development mode. Under Advanced, there is a feature which I recommend you leave on unless you have problems across all of your site, and that will speed up your Docker volumes and your site bootups. We could see a list of all of our blueprints, and you can install add-ons to extend the functionality of Local. You'll see the Reveal Add-ons folder, and this is where we would place any add-ons we download or create ourselves. I'll show you two of these in actions, Ports and Volumes Manager, which comes from the Local team. So if we come into a site with these installed, we'll see under More, Ports, which will show us all of the default ports that we're using, as well as Volumes, which will show us the mapping of different tools in Local, as well as give us the ability to remap different folders. For example, if we wanted a certain plugin to live in a different folder than inside of our app folder, we could set up that path here. Super handy feature for developers, especially those working with version controls or themes and plugins that they don't want to always be saving or updating inside of Local itself.
Hopefully, from all of this, you've gotten a nice look at some of the great features that Local offers developers. Now, I'd suggest you take the time to try out some of them for yourself.